Welcome to part one of Airframe 4. The HX50's fourth prototype airframe is going to be a big leap in development. It's an exciting time as we start applying in the foams and the B surface to the airframe. This is obviously a huge step and I can't wait to show you guys exactly what is happening down at DC 2 and 3. So without further ado, let's get going guys. Standing here in front of Airframe 3, which is a huge achievement in terms of detail. That was what we really focused on. Now Airframe 4 is shifting our focus a little bit onto the foams and obviously the inner surface for the airframe. This is going to be a complete infusion with the A surface, the B surface and the foams. The metallic inserts are to come in a further airframe, but this airframe coming is going to be obviously a really big push to include all of these extra details. Sometimes it can be a little bit like two steps forward, one step back. That's always the case in development. You learn new things and then you apply what has already been learned in the past to refine it. And that is exactly what Airframe 4 is going to be like.
Airframe number 4 is on its way. We started laminating beginning of last week. All the first skins are in, first stage is done, reinforcings are in, the molds are all bolted together, and we're at the foam stage. The foams are 50% machined. We should have 100% of the foams by late Friday. Saturday at the latest, I'm told. By Friday evening, we hope to have all the foams that we have fitted, the inner skins on them, and then we'll work the weekend to finish off the fitting foams, finish the laminating, and next week we'll be into bagging for infusing number 4 airframe. And number 4 airframe is the next big stage in the development. It's been what, 10 months? 10 months, and we're already at this stage, which is, I think, pretty impressive. The guys have worked extremely hard to get to this level where we're at.
Now you might be wondering, why are you putting foam inside of the HX50? Is it to help with the structure? No, literally the only reason we're using foam is as a space filler. It helps divide the A surface from the B surface without the center filling up with resin or just collapsing in on itself. It's to create that interior form. Now the reason we use a foam, and it is a high density foam, is because we do not want the resin to seep throughout the space filler, creating more unnecessary weight. That's why something like honeycomb would not work, because the entire space filler would fill with resin. And that is the reason why we use high density foam as a space filler. So that brings us to the end of part one of Airframe 4. Now I'm sure you guys are as excited as I am to see it finished. So stay tuned for the next video. It's only gonna get better guys. We'll see you next time.